Well, good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to Christ the King School for our spring drama production of The Wizard of Oz. I would like to open this event with, as we do all things, with prayer. So if you'll please pray with me in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Heavenly Father, we come before you thankful for all of the blessings that you bestow upon us, especially the blessing that is Christ the King School. We thank you for all of the talents that you have given our young thespians, and especially for the guidance and instruction of Miss Brown and Miss Hamill. Thank you for all that they have, all of these people have brought to our school, and we hope that their diligence and their hard work glorifies you. And we ask all of this through Christ our Lord, amen. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. And without further ado, The Wizard of Oz.
I need it.
Woo!
What's that word?
Edification.
Edification.
What's that mean?
Not now.
Allow us to present to you our production of
The Wizard of Oz.
The Wizard of Oz? That's my favorite.
Pipe down.
Our story begins in
Kansas.
Kansas? Yuck.
Have you ever wanted to go far, far away?
I would like to go to Hollywood and become a big movie star.
I would like to go to New York and climb buildings like King Kong.
Dorothy lived on a farm in Kansas.
Hey, this is supposed to be about me, remember?
Every day, Dorothy sat by herself.
Hey, don't forget about me.
Sorry, every day Dorothy sat with her little dog, Toto.
Toto was kind of a funny dog.
He walked on 2 feet and looked very much like a child. Hey.
But Dorothy loved him all the same.
Dorothy always wished that she could go far, far away.
Oh, Toto, I just wish I could go somewhere over that rainbow. I just know there's more to the world than this, and I so very badly want to see it.
Little did Dorothy know that her life was just about to change.
Whoa. Oh. Suddenly, there was a terrible storm.
In the distance, Dorothy could see a funny-looking cloud.
Oh, no, it's a cyclone! Dorothy!
Dorothy, come away!
Yes, of course. Let's go, Toto. We're all going down to the storm shelter. Toto? Toto was so scared of cyclones that he ran into the house and hid under the bed. Let him go, Dorothy.
I can't leave Toto.
Where are you, Toto? There you are. There's no time for hide and seek. Let's go. Follow me.
But it was too late.
The house began to shiver.
The house began to shake.
And suddenly, the cyclone ripped the house right off the ground.
And Dorothy and Toto looked out the window to see
they were flying in the sky.
Oh, Toto, hold on to me.
They saw houses.
They saw trees.
They saw bicycles.
And even cows.
Flying by.
Suddenly,
kerplunk!
The house fell to the ground.
We did it.
Thank you.
think it's all over, Toto. Follow me.
Dorothy pushed open the door.
I don't think we're in Kansas anymore, Toto.
Hello there.
Who are you?
Everyone knows who she is.
I'm Glinda, the Good Witch of the North.
Witch? You don't look wicked at all.
That's because I'm a good witch.
The question is...
Who are you?
I'm Dorothy, from Kansas.
Is Kansas a very big kingdom?
Kansas isn't a kingdom.
Nope, not a kingdom.
Do you have any magic in Kansas?
No, mostly we have cornfields.
You're a very funny witch.
I'm not a witch.
Welcome to Oz, Dorothy.
We want to welcome you to Munchkinland and to thank you from the bottom of our hearts.
For killing the bad witch of the east.
I haven't killed anyone.
Then how do you explain that?
Dorothy looked to where her house had fallen
and saw that two red shoes were sticking out.
Oh no, she must have been beneath the ground when we hit the floor.
Those are your ruby slippers, Dorothy.
They are awfully pretty.
Put them on. How do they make you feel?
They make me feel magical.
You must never take them off or give them to anyone. Those are very important magical shoes, Dorothy.
Oh, I won't. Only Auntie and might not approve. Nobody wears ruby slippers in Kansas. That reminds me, I have to get back home to Kansas. Can you tell me which way that is?
You can't get there from here, Dorothy.
What do you mean?
There's no Kansas around here, Dorothy.
You'll have to stay with us.
But I can't stay here. I have to get back home.
The only one who can help you, Dorothy, is the wonderful Wizard of Oz.
The great, the wise!
The wonderful!
The wonderful Wizard of Oz!
And how do I get there?
You must follow the yellow brick.
Yellow brick.
Yellow brick.
Follow the yellow brick road.
Dorothy looked at the yellow brick road at her feet and thought it was the prettiest color she'd ever seen.
Just follow the yellow brick.
Yellow brick.
Yellow brick.
Follow the yellow brick road.
Thank you all very much.
Remember what I told you about the ruby slippers?
Oh, I won't forget.
Good luck, Dorothy.
Best wishes.
Tally-hoo.
Tally-hoo.
Thank you. Goodbye. Yellow brick road. Follow the yellow brick road. Oh, Toto, we've been walking for such a long time. I'm just so tired.
Dorothy and Toto walked for miles and miles. After a while, they sat down to take a rest.
Hello there, young lady.
Who said that?
Me, over here.
But you can't talk. You're a scarecrow.
I beg your pardon. You don't know much about scarecrows, do you?
I know they don't talk. Or at least none of the ones in Kansas do.
Well, maybe they don't have much to say. At any rate, I'd be most grateful if you could help me out here.
Sure. What do you need?
This pole is stuck up my back. If you could just take it away?
Certainly.
Thank you. I feel like a new man. Who are you, and where are you going?
I'm Dorothy, from Kansas, and I'm on my way to go see the great and wise and wonderful Wizard of Oz, so I can go back home.
Who's the Wizard of Oz?
You don't know who he is?
Well, actually, I don't know anything. I haven't got a brain.
Oh, I'm awfully sorry.
Say, do you think the wizard could give me a brain?
I don't see why not.
Then I'll come with you.
Of course. Stop that, Toto. Don't worry, he never bites.
Oh, I'm not afraid of dogs. If they bite, I can't feel it. There's only one thing I'm afraid of.
What's that?
A lighted match.
Well, I don't expect we'll be running into too many of those.
Alrighty.
Scarecrow, are you ready?
Ready.
Toto, are you ready?
We're ready.
Then we're off.
We're off.
We're off.
We're off to see the wizard, the wonderful wizard of Oz.
Until they came to a grove of trees.
Oh, we've been walking for such a long time. I'm so hungry.
As a scarecrow, I never get hungry. But look, apples. I'll get one for you, Dorothy.
Hey, keep your hand to yourself and put that back.
Oh, I'm terribly sorry. Dorothy was hungry and I just thought...
You just thought you'd steal apples.
Well, I didn't think it was stealing, exactly.
That's right, you didn't think at all.
Actually, I can't think. I haven't got a brain.
You can say that again.
Hey, that's not fair. He didn't mean to do anything wrong.
Go on, beat it.
This is our part of the forest. Go find your own hangout.
I'm on, Dorothy. Come on.
Sure, we'll be happy to get out of your forest.
Hey, look.
Did you hear that?
Yeah. It sounds like a moan of some kind. A man made of tin. Did you just groan?
Con.
It sounds like...
Oil can.
Oil can? He wants us to oil him.
Oh, that feels good. I've been staying here for more than a year. You were the first people to come along.
Where would you like us to oil you?
My neck first, please. Now my arms. I've been holding that axe ever since I rested. If you would just oil my legs. How could I ever thank you? You saved my life. How did you happen to come through here?
We're on our way to see the great Wizard of Oz. He's going to give me a brain.
And send me back to Kansas.
Do you think the wizard could give me a heart?
I don't see why not.
Why, don't you have a heart?
I did once. I was in love with a pretty little munchkin girl. But then the wicked witch of the West took my heart away. And now I know the worst thing that could happen is to have your heart taken away. Because, I mean, you can never be happy again.
If you do get your heart back, will you marry the pretty munchkin girl?
Oh, yes. It'll make me the happiest man in the world.
And so, the Tin Man decided to go along with them to Oz.
Scarecrow, are you ready?
Ready.
Tin Man, are you ready?
Just let me oil my ankles. Ready.
Toto, are you ready?
Ready.
Then we're off.
We're off.
We're off.
We're off.
We're off to see the wizard, the wonderful Wizard of Oz.
still paved with yellow brick.
And the deeper they went into the forest, the scarier it became.
Suddenly, Toto noticed a low snore coming from the bushes.
Huh?
Who said that?
Hmm?
Who dared disturb my slumber? Was it you? Was it you?
Huh?
Ah, it was you! Stop that! Stop that right now! It's not polite! But I'm king of the forest. I'm not supposed to be polite, am I?
Doesn't matter who you are. Everyone has to be polite. And to go after a poor little dog and a scarecrow and a tin man?
But I'm a lion, see?
You're nothing but a coward.
I know it. I've always known it. How can I help it?
There now.
I'm a big coward.
But what makes you such a coward?
I don't know. I guess I was just born this way.
But that's not right. You're supposed to be the great king of the forest.
Maybe you have a heart disease. If you do, you should be glad, for I have no heart at all.
Maybe if I didn't have a heart, I wouldn't be such a coward.
Well, do you have a brain?
I suppose so. I've never really looked to see.
Sounds solid to me. We're on our way to the great Wizard of Oz. He's going to give me a brain. As you can see, my head is stuffed with hay.
Do you think the wizard could give me courage?
Just as easily as he could give me a brain.
Or give me a heart.
Or send me back to Kansas.
Then I'll go with you. But only if you don't mind.
That was a very polite way to put it. Of course you can come with us. Scarecrow, are you ready?
Ready.
Tin Man, are you ready?
Ready.
Lion, are you ready?
Ready.
Toto, are you ready?
Ready.
Ruff. Then we're off.
We're off.
We're off.
We're off.
We're off.
We're off to see the wizard, the wonderful Wizard of Oz.
So they set out again for the Emerald City.
These flowers. Aren't they beautiful?
But beautiful.
That when you breathe in the perfume of too many flowers, they can make you sleepy.
Very, very sleepy.
Oh no, what are we going to do?
The flower's perfume is putting them to sleep.
I think I'll take a little nap.
Oh no, the lion's falling asleep too.
You get the lion, I'll get Dorothy and the dog.
Come on, you big lug.
This way!
You know what? I think it's safe here. Let's let them sleep.
Yes, let them sleep.
Thank you.
they woke up, they realized that they were sleeping in the wizard's front yard.
Scarecrow, wake up.
Why? It's the Emerald City.
It has to be.
Look how it sparkles in the sun.
Come on.
So they hurried to the wizard's front door.
Until they came to a big green door that studded with diamonds and jewels.
Dorothy rang the bell.
And the lion knocked.
Stop that!
Stop what?
Stop ringing that infernal bell! How could you do such a thing at this hour?
But it's 11 o'clock in the morning.
Exactly! Coming in at a decent hour.
Please, sir, we come to see the wizard.
And what makes you think he will see you?
Well, we've come an awfully long way and...
The deep, dark forest.
Very deep, very deep.
I don't care where you've come from. Go away. Again?
You're not being very polite, sir.
I am the gatekeeper to Oz. I don't have to be polite.
Yes, you do. Everyone has to be polite.
Really? I'd never heard that before. Are you sure?
Very sure.
Well, then I suppose I'd better let you in.
Does this mean you'll let us see the wizard?
Of course not. I'm merely being polite.
Please, sir. They told us the wizard could help.
And what will he do for you?
He'll give me a brain.
And me a heart.
And give me courage.
And what do you expect me to do about it?
Like I said, they told us the wizard could help us.
They did. Did they? Who are they?
Glinda and the Munchkins.
Eek! Munchkins. I hate Munchkins.
They were awfully kind to me.
All right. I'll take you to see the wizard. But you be polite, young lady. Everyone has to be polite, you know.
The gatekeeper led them to a very large room.
This is the throne room.
It sparkled with dazzling emeralds.
There was a great chair, and above the chair
was a head that seemed to float in the air.
I am the great and the wise and the wonderful Wizard of Oz. How dare you disturb me from my wizardness? Who are you? Explain yourselves.
I'm Dorothy from Kansas, and these are my friends. They told us you could help us.
Why should I do this for you?
Because you are strong and I'm weak. Because you're a great wizard and I'm just a little girl.
You have no right to ask me to do anything for you. Unless you do something for me.
What would you like me to do for you?
Kill the Wicked Witch of the West.
But I can't do that.
Go away and do not bother me until you have done so.
But what about us? I still need a brain.
And I need a heart.
And I need courage.
Yes, well, you must help Dorothy kill the Wicked Witch of the West. Don't come back until you have done what I have asked. I have spoken.
Don't cry, Dorothy.
But I'm never going to get back to Kansas, no.
We'll help you, Dorothy. I'll scare her like I scared the crows.
I'll bop her with my trusty axe.
And I'll roar so ferocious you think I already have courage.
You, Dorothy, follow me. I'll show you where to go.
And so the sad group set off on their journey.
Good luck.
Thank you.
used a powerful telescope and could see everywhere.
Well, isn't that sweet? What's the little girl's name? Well, I don't please. They are trespassing in my territory. Where did they come from? Never, I tell you, never. I've got a great surprise for that silly Wizard of Oz. Get them, my pretties. Bring them to me.
So the flying monkeys
look,
set out to do as the witch had ordered.
They must work for the witch.
Run!
And the flying monkeys carried them away!
Ha ha ha! I know what you're up to. The wizard sent you to kill me. Isn't that amusing? Hey, Scarecrow, catch!
The witch threw a burning torch at him.
How could you?
They don't call me wicked for nothing, just fighting a little fire with fire. Seize them. Take the Scarecrow to the barn and scatter him around the hay. And take the Tin Man to the waterfall. That ought to rest you up nicely. And that great lion? Ha ha ha! Harness him like a donkey and put him to work.
You wicked thing!
There's my broomstick, sweet Dorothy. Get to work.
Suddenly, the witch noticed something she had never seen before.
Those shoes. Those ruby slippers. Where did you get them?
Well, you see, I accidentally killed the Wicked Witch of the East. And I didn't mean to, but Glinda told me to take her shoes.
Glinda? Glinda? I'll get that good witch back. Give me those shoes.
No, get away from me! Sorry, I didn't mean to.
All hail Dorothy! Hip, hip, hooray!
What do you mean? I just killed her.
She was a very evil witch. We don't understand you, Dorothy.
All hail Dorothy! Hip, hip, hooray!
Oh, please get up. Don't pledge yourselves to me. I'm only a little girl. You know what? There's one thing you could do for us if you don't mind.
What's that?
You could take us back to Oz.
Yes, let's go back to the wizard and claim our promise.
Let's go! So they climbed onto the flying monkey's backs and flew all the way back to Oz.
Thank y'all.
All hail Dorothy! Hip, hip, hooray!
They were awfully nice monkeys.
Ring the bell, Dorothy.
Dorothy, back again already? Didn't the Wicked Witch of the West capture you?
She did for a while.
And she let you get away?
She couldn't stop us. See? Here's a broomstick to prove it.
Goodness gracious, wait till the wizard hears about this.
And the wise and the wonderful Wizard of Oz.
Yes, sir. We know who you are. Don't you remember us?
I remember everything because I am so great and wise.
Yes, sir. You've told us this already. It's not polite to repeat yourself.
But I'm the wizard, the wonderful wizard.
Yes, yes. And we've come to claim our promises.
Promise? What promise? I don't remember any promise.
You promised to send me back to Kansas.
And to give me a brain.
And me a heart.
And give me courage.
Yes, well, come back tomorrow.
I can't come back tomorrow. We've come such a long way, and I want to go home to Kansas now.
Please, sir, you have to keep your promise to us.
Toto, stop!
Who are you?
I am Oz, the great, the wise, the...
You're not a wizard at all. You've been lying to us.
I'm afraid so. I am what you see here, an ordinary man. I was riding a hot air balloon one day, and wind carried me to Oz.
This is terrible. How will I ever get a brain now?
I think you're a very bad man.
No, my dear, I'm a good man, but I'm a very bad wizard.
How will I ever get a brain?
Well, it may be true that I can't work magic, but I might be able to help.
You can give me a brain?
You really don't need them, you know. You learn something new every day, and that's how one gets smart. But I do think I have some fresh hay around here. Here it is. Let's stuff this in there. And then, of course, I can give you my diploma.
Diploma?
From the University of Omaha. Here you go. How do you feel?
I before E, except after C. Hey!
Spell Mississippi.
M-I-S-S-I-S-S-I-P-P-I. It works!
And as for your heart, I've been saving this from a Valentine's Day long ago. A pretty little girl gave it to me. If it has any love left in it, it should do the trick.
Is it a kind heart?
Yes, very.
Then it's perfect.
What about my courage?
Very well, I'll get it for you.
The wizard goes to the very bottom of the chest.
Drink.
What is it?
Well, if it were inside of you, it would be courage. Courage is always inside of you. If you're brave enough to drink what's in the bottle, then you will have courage.
I'll do it.
How do you feel?
Like the king of the forest. Roar!
What about Dorothy? How will she get back to Kansas?
That's a tricky one, but I do think I have a solution. I came here in a hot air balloon, but of course I was destroying the landing. But I've been building a new one out of silk and hot air.
Really?
The wizard unveiled his balloon.
I don't know which direction Kansas is in, but I do believe this will get us closer to it than we are in the moment.
Really? Let's go, Toto.
Climb on.
Toto, where did you go? We can't miss it again.
Hurry up, Dorothy.
There you are, Toto. Let's go. Hurry.
Can't you see the ropes are snapping, Dorothy? Climb on.
Missed it again.
I'm so sorry. I can't come back. Goodbye.
How will you ever get home now?
Glinda?
I've heard all about your travels, Dorothy. You want to go home to Kansas very badly.
Yeah, I really do. I have.
It's in your ruby slippers. Remember how I told you that they're magical? All you have to do is put your heels together 3 times and say there's no perfect home. And in the blink of an eye, you will be home.
I guess this really is goodbye now. Be good, Dorothy.
Stay strong.
Go home to the ones you love.
Well, it's worth a try. There's no place like home. There's no place like home. There's no place like home.
There's no place like home. There's no place like home.
Auntie Em and Uncle Henry had just gone out to water the cabbages.
Uncle Henry!
Oh, my darling child, where have you been?
I've been in a place you can only imagine.
Where are the ruby slippers?
Well, I guess I don't need them anymore, Toto. After all, there's no place like home.
Home at last!
Those bottle things.
Yep, let's go.
Thank you.
As you can hear the cheer of the kids in the back, that's amazing. They did an amazing job. Please do join us. Obviously, because of the rain, we've had to move things inside. And so we're going to be upstairs in the parish hall to enjoy some Cinco de Mayo treats as we celebrate the Wizard of Oz. So please join us upstairs in the parish hall.